Insan Edukasi, kembali lagi kita berjumpa dalam Bimbingan Belajar seri Ayo Belajar yang diproduksi oleh UPTD Balai Pengembangan Teknologi Pendidikan Dinas Pendidikan dan Kebudayaan Provinsi Lampung. Kali ini kita akan belajar bahasa Inggris dengan judul Analytical Exposition untuk sekolah menengah atas kelas 11. Sahabat edukasi, sekarang kita akan sama-sama dengarkan percakapan teman-teman kalian dari SMA Negeri 4 Bandar Lampung, Safira, Puspita, Aindina, Talita, Vini, dan Ibu Lasma. Sekarang, mari kita simak percakapan mereka.
Hey Safira, you look gloomy. What happened?
Yeah, I think you're right, Talita. Are you broke up with your boyfriend, Safira?
Let me see. I think I agree. You look so sad. Or are your parents angry with you?
No. I'm confused with a new text I've just learned. Can you hear me read that text? I need your help. Are you ready, guys? Please listen to me.
Okay.
Do you agree that music is important for us?
Yes, I do.
Music plays an important role in our lives. Here are a few reasons why music plays an important role. First of all, music entertains us. There are many different kinds of music, from hip-hop, pop, rock, jazz, and etc. They are all entertaining. When we fall in love, we can listen to hip-hop music that will make us enthusiastic. Do you agree that music is important for us?
Yes, I do. Music plays an important role in our lives.
Here are a few reasons why music plays an important role. First of all, music entertains us. There are many different kinds of music, from hip-hop, pop, rock, jazz, and etc. They are all entertaining. When we fall in love, we can listen to hip-hop music that will make us enthusiastic. We can select pop when we feel sad to entertain us.
Yes, I agree with that opinion.
Ain, she have not finished yet.
Don't disturb her. Carry on, Saf.
All right, I continue, okay? Listen again.
Okay.
In addition, music creates memories. When we are in a relationship, we enjoy favorite music together. The favorite music reminds us about everything we have been through together. Certain favorite songs can help us build stronger relationship. Furthermore, music helps us focus on what we do. Music can help us feel enthusiastic towards our daily activities. We can keep our spirit in finishing our jobs. Even if we have several jobs that we have to complete urgently, music can help us focus on finishing the jobs and we will not feel tired.
Stop. Safira, you look so thirsty. You had better drink first. I will continue reading.
You know me so well.
Let me continue. Are you ready, guys?
Sure.
Finally, music can also boost our mood. When we feel sad, listen to music. Music can help us relieve our sadness. On the other hand, when we feel upset, listen to music. Music can also relieve our anger. Select the right music and you will feel much better. Thus, with the reason reflected above, music is really important for us.
So, what can we do for you, Saf?
I'm confused. What kind of text is that?
I think that is not a narrative text.
Yes, it is not a narrative text, Ain. The contents of the text are arguments.
Oh, there are many kinds of text that contains arguments. For example, discussion text, expositions, or what else, Ain?
Or maybe a debate.
Oh God, Ain, this is a kind of text. Meanwhile, debate is not a kind of text.
Stop it, guys. Don't argue. How about after school ends, we are going to Mem Lasma's house to make everything clear.
Agree. Let's go.
Sahabat edukasi, percakapan sebelumnya adalah mengenai suatu bahan dari bahasa Inggris yang ingin kita pelajari yang terdapat dalam bentuk analytical exposition. Mereka menanyakan dan ingin mencari tahu tentang apakah yang dimaksud dengan analytical exposition, lalu apakah bentuk-bentuknya dan bentuk susunan teksnya. Di situasi yang kedua, kita akan mendengarkan bagaimana penjelasan dari bentuk analytical exposition. Edukasi, kembali kita akan lanjutkan tentang definisi dan susunan teks dari analytical exposition beserta ciri kebahasaannya.
Assalamualaikum, Mem Lasma.
Waalaikumsalam. Hey, you all. It's been long time not to see. What's up?
Mem Lasma, we want to ask you about a text. Here is the text.
Okay, so let me see. And what do you want to ask?
We are confused what kind of text it is. The contents of text are arguments, but there are a lot of the text with arguments.
Okay, so have you ever searched it on Google?
Not yet, ma'am. We come here to ask.
But let me check it first. Oh, the text is analytical exposition. But I don't know what kind of text is it.
So, let us see. You are asking about analytical exposition. This kind of text elaborates the writer's idea about the phenomenon surrounding. Its social function is to persuade the readers that the idea is important matter.
Oh, so that's analytical exposition. I want to know a lot about the text. Usually, every text has a generic structure. Right, ma'am? How about the generic structure of analytical exposition?
Okay, so you want to know about the generic structure. So, in the analytical exposition, it will be divided into three structures. The first one is thesis, the outlines of the main arguments to be presented. And the second is arguments. It can be argument or arguments. It depends on how many reasons you have. And it contains statements that support the thesis statement. And the last one is the reiteration, which restates the writer's position or the writer's opinion about the case. Jadi, anak-anak, apabila kita membicarakan tentang analytical exposition, ini kan suatu teks yang memberikan ide, yang menjelaskan tentang suatu fenomena. Tujuannya adalah untuk meyakinkan para pembaca bahwa suatu ide itu adalah penting. Suatu kasus tersebut adalah penting dengan beberapa alasan. Nah, dalam teks analytical exposition, kita akan memiliki tiga bagian. Bagian yang pertama adalah thesis statement. Thesis statement ini akan menggambarkan apa saja argumen atau alasan yang akan diberikan. Sedangkan bagian yang kedua adalah argumennya sendiri atau alasannya, di mana argumen tersebut akan memberikan beberapa hal yang menunjang thesis statement. Dan bagian yang terakhir adalah reiteration, yang kembali menekankan pentingnya hal yang sudah diutarakan di atas. Begitu ya.
What about the language features?
I know that. I have been looking for it before. The language features of analytical exposition are: the first is focus on generic human and non-human participants, such as music. The second is more use modality and modulation. The third is few temporal conjunctive relations, or mostly logical reasons, such as furthermore. Then, reasoning expressed as verbs and nouns. The last is use of material, relational, and mental processes.
Oh, now I understand about analytical exposition. I will sort the text according to its structures. So, listen me, guys. The thesis is this one. Do you agree that music is important for us? Yes, I do. Music plays an important role in our lives. Here are a few reasons why music plays an important role. And then, the arguments are this. First of all, music entertains us. In addition, music creates memories. Furthermore, music helps us focus on what we do. Finally, music can also boost our mood. Am I right, Ma'am Lasma?
Yes, Safira. All are correct. Then, how about the reiteration part? Puspita, which part do you think that shows the reiteration?
I think the reiteration part is thus. With the reasons reflected above, music is really important for us.
That is right. So, do you get the point of analytical exposition text?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for your help. We are glad that Ma'am Lasma has helped us to increase our knowledge.
Insan Edukasi, baru saja kita mendengarkan percakapan yang dapat menyimpulkan apa saja yang merupakan bagian dari analytical exposition, juga yang merupakan dari ciri kebahasaan dari analytical exposition. Selain itu, yang terpenting adalah kita mengerti bagaimana analytical exposition itu menjelaskan tentang sesuatu yang ada di dalamnya. Anak-anak, bagaimana? Apakah kita bisa melihat pemahaman kalian mengenai analytical exposition? Okay, students, now let me check your understanding about analytical exposition. Are you ready?
Alright, ma'am.
Now, this is my first question. What do you find in the first paragraph of analytical exposition? Who can answer this?
Me.
No, let me answer that. In the first paragraph, there will be a thesis statement. Thesis statement is the sentence that contains the main idea.
Let me add. I think it tells the readers what the case is.
One more. It says what the writer thinks about.
Yes, very good. You get it clearly.
Oh, one more, ma'am. At the end of the paragraph, it usually has some key points to be explained in the following paragraphs.
That's exactly true. Remember, the last sentence of paragraph 1 usually gives us the key points to be explained in the following paragraphs.
Can I ask one more question, ma'am?
Sure, go ahead.
So, that means when the last sentence of paragraph 1 tells two key points, then there will be two paragraphs to follow?
No, there will be three more paragraphs to follow. So, there will be four paragraphs actually. The first one is the thesis statement, and two more paragraphs for the argumentations, and the last one will be for the reiteration.
That means when there are two key points, we will read four paragraphs.
That is true. Baiklah, sahabat edukasi yang sudah mendengarkan siaran ini, itulah penjelasan dari analytical exposition text yang kalian pelajari sebagai bahan di kelas 11. Adapun bagiannya, lalu ciri kebahasaannya adalah hal yang terpenting dalam mempelajari analytical exposition. Dalam analytical exposition, bagaimana kita memberikan argumen berikut penjelasannya adalah hal yang paling penting.
Nah, sahabat edukasi, tadi sudah kita sama-sama dengarkan penjelasan dan pembelajaran bahasa Inggris bersama teman-teman kalian dari SMA Negeri 4 Bandar Lampung. Mudah-mudahan bermanfaat. Yang disiarkan dari gedung UPTD Balai Pengembangan Teknologi Pendidikan Dinas Pendidikan dan Kebudayaan Provinsi Lampung. Semoga bermanfaat dan sampai jumpa.